So this one may be an odd one that I'm going to look at today here on FTD Facts, but I'm going to look at one of the two most widely used fighters on the planet. Although one is much older than the other, there has been recent news and stories of MiG-21s shooting down F-16s, of course in the country of India and Pakistan. But however, today we look at the differences between them and figure out what makes these fighters still dangerous today, although some may have newer technology and some may be outdated. How's it going, everybody? What's up? Dave Walp here, and welcome to FTD Facts, the channel where I look at people, cultures, places, and military hardware and gear and divisions from all around the world. Yeah, we kind of do a lot of stuff here. But anyways, so today, yes, we're going to look at the MiG-21 and we're going to look at the F-16. I know a lot of you guys are like, what? Why would you even bother? The F-16 is clearly superior. But as stated, there was recent news about India and Pakistan, and a lot of you guys actually requested us to talk about these two fighters and compare them. So I'm going to do it. Originally, though, I was a little hesitant on it because, you know, I know down there in the comments section, people are just going to be blah, blah, blah against each other. Which, guys, I'm just going to say this right now. I do not have, I've not picked a side of whether or not one country is more guilty than the other. Here's the reason why. I've come to acknowledge that the people within different countries are great in their own unique way. But me, when it comes to situations of conflict and war, I don't know about you guys, but I don't even believe my own government is telling the truth of certain things. I know from the past governments lie, so that's why I don't really pick sides. But with that, let's get that out of the way. Let's just look at the facts of these two fighters. Let's get rocking and rolling. Now, why compare these? Well, first of all, the MiG-21 is one of the most produced aircrafts in the entire world, coming in with a total of 11,496. Now, of course, there's different versions and variants. I'm going to get into that later on in this video. But it's also really fascinating to know that the MiG-21 at one point had the record of being produced the longest of any fighter prior to the F-16's release. So how long have these fighters been in production for? Well, let's start off with the basics. So you got the MiG-21. It was introduced in 1959, made by the Soviet Union company known as Mikoyan-Gurevich. Basically, that's why you get MiG and the I in MIG is small. That's right. Now, this aircraft ran into production until 1985, with over 10,000 of them made in Russia. 657 of them, at least, were made in India alone. And of course, 194 of them were made in Czechoslovakia. India has been operating this aircraft since 1961, and as of today, they are the largest operators of this type of vehicle. And to add to that, of course, the F-16 in today's world may have more operators of all the countries in the world that it's currently in. The MiG-21, however, has a lot more countries of operation in history. However, I'm only going to list off the current ones because, let's be perfectly honest, going back in history, the list is long. Currently, in today's world, the MiG-29 is operated by the countries of Angola, Azerbaijan, Croatia, Cuba, Egypt, Guinea-Bissau, India, Libya, Mali, Mozambique, North Korea, Romania, Serbia, Sudan, Syria, Uganda, Yemen, and of course the country of Zambia. And in case you were wondering how long this aircraft was in production for, it was approximately 26 years. That, of course, doesn't mean the actual development stage of that. I'm not going to incorporate that either. The F-16, besides its initial flight tests and development stage, was introduced on August 17th, 1978. And as a matter of fact, they are still being produced today. However, in 2018, they took a little bit of a pause of producing them. This is because the F-16 factory from Texas moved to South Carolina, simply because the Texas factory was going to push the F-35. In total, as of 2018, there has been 4,604 of these aircrafts made, and they are still growing. There's a lot of countries that are still ordering this aircraft. As for operators, most countries that have an operational history still use it today, and it's proved to be a very great fighter because of that. And in today's world, you have the countries of the United States, obviously, that operates this vehicle. Israel, which is also the second largest F-16 user in the world. You have Pakistan, which had their aircrafts delivered in 1983. On top of that, you have Turkey, Egypt, the Netherlands, Belgium, Denmark, Venezuela, Norway, Jordan, UAE, Morocco, Bahrain, Greece, Iraq, Oman, Indonesia, Singapore, South Korea, the Republic of China, Thailand, Chile, Poland, and Romania. Basically, 28 countries at least. And also, to give you an idea, as of 2019, although this vehicle is still in production, this thing has been in production for over 40 years. Nuts. But you might be really fascinated to know that although production of the MiG-21 stopped in 1985, these aircrafts are still capable of shooting down an F-16, and there's been a lot of stories of this aircraft doing that. However, I'm not going to go into that news because we're talking about the specifics here, and with that, we're going to go into variants. For variants, the MiG-21 was all over the place with many different versions. For example, from 1957 to 1961, which is considered the first generation of this fighter, there were 13 different versions. The big one of these was the MiG-21F, which was the more common variant. These different versions and subversions had not only different equipment used with them, but also had different types of wings, such as delta and swept wing aircraft types. However, one thing to know about the MiG-21 is it was the first fighter to combine the fighter and interceptor characteristics in the country of Russia. This was a groundbreaking single-seat fighter, which that's the reason why Russia made so many of them. As well, there was the MiG-21P, which they upgraded to adopt a interceptor missile. And I'm not going to go through all the different versions. I mean, literally, you can see it on this list. There are just so bloody many. However, in the modern world, there is something called the MiG-21-93. This had upgraded radar, which was taken from the MiG-29. It also uses upgraded air-to-air missiles. There is also the MiG-21-2000 for Israel, as well as the MiG-21D and the MiG-21UMD, which is basically used for Croatia and is made for NATO compatibility. One of the big ones that I want to talk about, which a lot of you guys from India will know, is the MiG-21 Bison. This one is the main aircraft from India, and it uses a lot of their missiles. They also have a semi radar homing capability. This version was said to be equivalent to the early F-16s. India's also upgraded this aircraft to improve on the helmet mount sight, and it is even formidable against F-15Cs. Lastly though, the MiG-21-97, this one's the beast. Besides its upgrades from the MiG-21-93, it is said to be superior by Russian standards to an F-16, even beating them in a tested dogfight. However, with that fact, it's more or less a rumor. I couldn't find actual stats on that, but that's what's been said. But however, even if it's true, if they could beat them in a dogfight, let's be realistic, the modern day F-16s and past ones have a lot going for them. The F-16, however, may not have many different variants, but the United States was a little more organized in what they wanted the fighter to do. You have your initial A and B versions, which the B was a two-seater. However, these have been majorly replaced by the C and D, which came out in 1984. These variants had improved radar and all-weather capability and new types of missiles. There's also even the more upgraded version, which is the E and the F. They have conformable fuel tanks and a much more powerful engine, as well as upgraded radar as well. Now, India also has their very own version, which is called the F-16IN. This one has a lot of upgrades from the E and F equipment, but they also upgraded the cockpit glass and the helmet-mounted queuing system, as well as an upgraded electronic warfare and, most important, the infrared search and track unit. On top of that, there's also the F-16Q and the N. There's also the F-16V and the QF-16, which that particular version is a unmanned, robotically controlled F-16. So we got variants out of the way. Let's look at numbers, range, combat radius, all that sort of thing. For the length of the MiG-21 comes in at 14.7 meters. The width or wingspan is approximately 7.14 meters with a height of 4. The F-16 has a length of 15.06 meters with a width of 9.96 and a height of 4.88 meters. Basically, you got your MiG-21, which is a little bit smaller, but not by much. The MiG-21 also has a loaded weight of 19,230 pounds. That is with 2x K-13A missiles with a maximum takeoff weight of approximately 21,600 pounds. The F-16, however, can carry a lot more, as it has a loaded weight of 26,500 pounds and a maximum takeoff weight of 42,300 pounds, which means you can carry heavier equipment, heavier guns, heavier bombs, that sort of thing. The MiG-21 has a speed at sea level of Mach 1.05. However, if it gets to the height of 42,640 feet, it can go Mach 1.76. The range of this aircraft is approximately 1,470 kilometers, which is also 910 miles, and it has a service ceiling of 57,400 feet. The F-16, however, is much faster. It can go at a speed of Mach 1.2, but however, at a much higher altitude, it is capable of going Mach 2. However, its combat radius is much smaller, of 340 miles, which is also 550,000 kilometers. Keep in mind, though, its ferry range can be upgraded to 2,260 miles, or 4,220 kilometers with drop tanks. The service ceiling for this aircraft is over 50,000 feet. And now let's take a look at armaments. Basically, your MiG-21 has a 1x internal 23mm autocannon with 200 rounds. And unfortunately, it only has 4 hardpoints that can hold a capacity of 4,400 pounds. However, of course, this aircraft can be loaded with many different types of munitions. The F-16 has a 1x20mm autocannon, which is a 6-barrel rotary cannon with 511 rounds. Its hardpoints, however, is much more, with a 2x wingtip air-to-air missile launch rails, and as well a 6x underwing and a 3x underfuel silage pylon. And for it, it is capable of holding 17,000 pounds. Both of these aircrafts can be loaded with rockets, air-to-ground missiles, and air-to-air missiles. However, the F-16 specializes more in anti-ship and can carry 4 to up to 12 times bombs. Either way, guys, that is a look at these two particular aircrafts. I want to know your thoughts on it. Yes, of course, the MiG-21 is a far less superior aircraft in terms of numbers. But you got to remember the fact there are a lot of them out there, and they are still a very dangerous fighter. But let me know your thoughts on it down there in the comment section below. My name is Dave Wobble, and I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Now, before you guys get out of here, just to let you guys know, we've done a lot of different playlists on different types of militaries around the world. I'm going to put some of our playlists in the comment section down below at the end of this video and in the cards above. Feel free to check those out. It's really good, especially if you like learning about different militaries from different places or even your own country. So thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Okay, guys, so here are those playlists that I was telling you about. You guys want to look at them and learn as much as you possibly can. I love learning about militaries, and I love comparing different militaries. It's kind of interesting. So feel free to check them out. Hit that subscribe button. We'll see you later. Bye-bye.